Casey Klaus with Lifestyles Realty, and I want to talk to you about overcoming criticisms from family and friends. You're getting into the investment world, you're going to have family, your friends, your sphere of influence, sometimes want to talk you out of it. And you know in the back of your mind that this is the right move for you, but anytime that you get negativity, then it could derail what you're trying to do. Paradigm is this: you're gonna go to school, you're gonna go to college, you're gonna get a job, you're gonna work 40 years, hopefully get that golden watch, and then you're gonna rely on some type of pension to retire, right? And hopefully you're gonna have this huge nest egg that you can whittle down 4% or whatever the financial planners tell you nowadays before you die. So that plan, I think, isn't gonna work. Reality is this: people are going to school, they're taking out massive student loans, and they're not able to buy houses or go forward or become financially independent or retirement. Financial independence is not a number at 65 years old anymore. It's an idea. How do I get enough passive income from my rentals or dividends or royalties or whatever to cover my expenses every time, every month? I need to be able to cover my nuts. I need to be able to make enough money that comes in to pay all of my bills. Steve Davis talks about it. He says it's my taxes, my tuna fish, my toilet paper, everything that I need. If that number for you typically is about $3,000 $4,000, well, at Lifestyles Unlimited, we're teaching you how to buy rental properties. You only need about eight properties. Eight properties at $400 a month cash flow is $3,200. And you're financially independent. Can you retire? Sure, you don't have to go back to work. But if you're 35 years old and you've already completed that task, you're not gonna just sit on the beach for, you know, months at a time. After about a week or so, you're gonna be bored, you're ready to keep working. So you just keep going on and on and on. This is a new idea, and when you're talking to your family, your friends, people that have not accomplished financial independence, this is foreign material, they're gonna come back at you with negativity. They're gonna say, oh, that's not gonna work. I had this guy over here, my Uncle Bob, did real estate, and he got burned and it didn't work. Or, why aren't you sticking your money into a 401k? Because that's all they've heard. That's all they've been taught their whole lives, is 401s and IRAs, and find a good job, a stable job that pays for your insurance. Where we're talking about taking care of yourself, you can make more money. You have more control of your time if you're an entrepreneur. If you're already buying real estate, that's the whole idea, is to buy more time. Time is your number one asset. So I don't ask financial advice for people that are broke. If you're going to ask how to do something, you need to ask and talk to people that have already done it. If your mom or dad or family or friends or whoever hasn't already become what you want to become, you can discuss your plans with them, but you're not going to talk to them about advice, you know, because they've been taught this paradigm for 40 years. And they're going to teach you that same thing that they know, but that old paradigm doesn't work anymore.